I believe that nobody likes to change anything in his life if there is not a real incentive, if there is not a benefit, if there is not the confidence that it will be better afterward. And this is why you have to change the narrative today. Protection of the environment is not something boring and expensive. It is something exciting and economically profitable. Until now, the industry and the economy believed that it was detrimental for the development to protect the environment. And in order to make them part of the action, I wanted to show them that it's an economical advantage to protect the environment, to be more ecological, to be more efficient, to seize new business opportunity. All this is available. And if you put ecology at the core of the economical development, you will be much more successful. You need to show that the solutions exist. You need to show they are profitable, they are applicable. This is what I'm doing with my foundation. So we're already changing some legislations in different countries, the way of doing in certain corporations. We are working with some industries to help to modernize and decarbonize. So it's an ongoing process. We haven't changed the world entirely, and we are not able to do it alone. So we need to also work this out with different industries and corporations. And we are having partnerships with different corporations in order to spread that message, to develop these actions together. My experience with politicians is that it is fashionable to say that everybody is going to be carbon neutral in 2050, but they have no idea how to reach these goals. And this is why at the Soil & Pulse Foundation, we're bringing the toolbox. Today, more than 1,500 profitable solutions to protect the environment, in order to show them how, practically speaking, they can reach their targets. Okay. Doing more of the same is detrimental for the economy as much as for the ecology. And today we need to aim at efficiency. Efficiency is when you can produce better with a lower consumption of resource. And this leaves a higher margin profit. And this is possible in absolutely every field today of the industry. And this is what I believe the industrial and the financial and economical people have to understand. The incumbent companies who are resisting to the change have to remember the Kodak story. Resisting to the change is really detrimental. Kodak disappeared because they were fighting against the evolution of pictures into digital mode. And today, the ones who are really focusing only on what they are doing and don't want to change are going to disappear. Because the trend today is going in another direction. And if they want to be successful, they have to take this new trend. We always have to show the example. Because reaching the impossible is not an action, it's a way of thinking. It's a way of showing that if we manage to do and think in another way than what we have learned, it brings much more options. I believe that Andreessen and Hauser already lead with the quality of their product and the application of these products. They can be used everywhere to be more efficient, to control better, to measure better. And the real-time measurement is actually the only way to reduce the waste of energy, the waste of resource, the waste of energy or water or whatever. You only waste if you don't notice how much inefficient you are. And I think Andreessen Hauser are helping the clients to be more efficient. That's why I was very happy to give a speech today. Yeah.